Good evening and welcome to Rockwiz Rewind, a program where we revisit some of our favourite Rockwiz episodes. This week we're going to be seeing the episode that featured Billy Miller from 70s Australian band The Ferrets, and he's teamed up with
Stephanie Dosen. Stephanie Dosen's a Canadian-born singer-songwriter who now lives in England, and she was on her first trip to Australia and she agreed to come on the show and perform with our lovable rock icon, Billy Miller. And where can you see Billy? He's always working hard, isn't he?
Oh, he's always working hard. He loves his 60s and 70s pop. In fact, Stephanie and Billy closed the show with a soul pop gem from the 60s, I believe.
Not telling you what it is.
Not telling you what it is, but you hang in there and wait for it. It's well worth it.
Enjoy.
Are these not men? Answer, they are the Rockwiz Orchestra. A hearty welcome, please, to Peter Luscombe, Mark Berry, and James Black. And now, put your hands together for the host with the most, and that's no idle boast, the original and the best, Julia Samira.
Devilgate Drive, hopped on the freeway of love, took the highway to hell exit and hung a right on the road to nowhere. I crossed Orchard Road, Thunder Road and Hard Road, did a U into Yellow Brick Road, then got lost because the streets had no names. Oh yeah, I got a million of them. Actually, help me out, would you? Ready? Copperhead.
Road.
6 days on the...
Road.
Why don't we do it in the...
Road.
The long and winding
road.
Venturer
road.
Good Penny
road.
Oh, enough already. Well done, as always, keeping things on the straight and narrow. Please welcome the Sultan of Swing, Brian Nankervis.
Thank you, Julia. And thanks, too, to everybody who emailed us this week with questions about the show. Michael from Spotswood, yes, Dougald will return. And no, he is not a robot from the future. Yes, Lockie from Mullumbimby, I do all my own stunts. And Fran from Fremantle, you're quite right, Zamiro spelled backwards is Oromez, a French term for I buried my parakeet in the backyard.
About that. Ladies and gentlemen, to bring you contestants that are the absolute cream of the Rockwiz crop, we start with 24 true believers and slowly we eliminate the pretenders. Here they are.
Julia.
Welcome.
Thanks for having us. It's
good.
Great.
You're doing a bit of moving the mic. Good. Make them your own. Bring them to you.
Sorry.
Now, Neil, what was the first concert you ever went to?
It was Wendy and the Rockets at the Sandown Hotel.
Oh. And wasn't she gorgeous?
She was great. Yeah.
She was great. Anthony, welcome.
Hi.
Anthony, have you come from work? You look like you're in a
business
shirt. Totally. Have
yeah.
you? What do you do for a craft?
Oh, IT work. Yeah.
Don't apologise. We
mean,
all need
I'm cool with it.
Now, Anthony, first concert?
Yeah, Pearl Jam at Exhibition Park in Canberra.
Oh. But Canberra didn't know what hit it when Pearl Jam came.
Yeah, it was cool.
Good grief. And your first album?
It'd be Prince Batman soundtrack.
Sometimes a movie opens up a whole world of music for one. Well done. Hello, Belinda, another woman on the team. Very happy with that. Belinda, first concert?
It was Silverchair at Festival Hall.
Oh, lovely. How old were they at this stage?
Very young.
Very young, yeah. Freaks, one and all. Extraordinary. And your first album?
It's really, really embarrassing.
No, come on.
This is really embarrassing.
All right.
E17, Walthamstow.
Well, Belinda, I do believe that is embarrassing. But that's why we're here. We purge and we move on. Well done. And finally, Aaron, welcome.
Hi, Julian.
Woo!
On the table.
Oh. Now, the first concert you ever went to?
That was Cole Chisel's Last Stand.
Oh.
At the Perth Entertainment Centre.
Oh, there you go.
I was 12, and the bloke who brought me is my cousin, and he's here tonight.
Oh, so that's a lovely full circle. Look at that. Well, now the circle is almost complete, except for the bit where it joins up. To complete our metaphorical ring, we must meet tonight's two musicians, but who can they be now? Who can it be now? I was born in the United States and was raised on a peacock farm in Wisconsin. My favourite things as a child were my pet swan, my pet fox, and an old guitar that I found in a dusty attic. It was during a busy peacock feather harvest that I started writing songs for the boys at school, my pets, and some of the ghosts that lived on the farm. These days I record my songs on a tape player called Jean-Pierre. I'm based in London now and working with Simon Raymond from the Cocteau Twins, although at the moment I've been touring Australia with my friend Holly Throsby.
Stephanie Dosen.
Please make a very welcome Stephanie Dosen!
Just getting up, sun, it makes my blood shine.
welcome. We are delighted to have you here. Now, Stephanie, it's not often that one can say one has grown up on a peacock farm. What does that entail?
Sort of maybe coaxing them and then milking them.
No. You don't milk a peacock, do you?
You do. Yes, you absolutely do. I do.
Sure. And well, you might. And were they always fanning themselves open?
All the time, constantly.
Mainly the men, I understand. The peahen is not particularly beautiful, but the peacock is a delight.
Lovely.
Lovely, good.
The best milk.
The best milk, naturally. You and I share a passion.
Oh.
Olivia Newton-John. Really? Olivia Newton-John.
You understand?
Yes, I understand.
Thank you.
I understand. And we will talk about that later on.
That's
great.
But
it's wonderful to meet someone who's on the same level.
I'm
very
on the page
exciting.
That you are on.
Oh, you are on. Now, out of interest, Stephanie, the first concert you ever went to?
I honestly can't remember if it was Crosby, Stills and Nash or the Sugar Cubes. But it was one of those.
Gee, that's pretty good news.
I know. It was the same week because it was a festival, so.
And how was Björk? Was she great?
Yeah. She's wearing a big yellow jumpsuit that looked kind of like she was just awesome.
Of course she was. Yes. I love you a little bit more now, Stephanie.
Thanks.
Because you've mentioned Björk. And first album or CD you ever bought of your own money?
Miss Olivia Newton-John physical. $7 at Target.
Target, okay. Yeah, that's where all the good music comes from, Target, I do believe. Stephanie, you're a delight. Welcome. Now, who is next on board? Stephanie has been meted and greeted, but who will match musical brains with her? Without further ado, who can it be now? Depending on who you talk to, I'm either a walking encyclopedia of the history of the St Kilda Football Club or one of Australia's greatest bad boy rock stars of the 70s. Either or both is fine by me. I started performing in the 60s and my first break came in the original cast of Jesus Christ, in the early 70s. Sorry, had to do that. I ferreted around for a while in the 70s, but I knew the key to success was not to fall in love. Yes, Neil.
Billy Miller.
Please, make him very welcome. Billy Miller!
Fuck!
As a 15-year-old watching Countdown, where that song was number one for so many weeks, it went, oh, not again. Jesus. But it was a huge success.
Yeah.
It went gold. And Molly Meldrum was your manager.
And our producer.
And your producer.
And our dresser? No.
Your dresser.
Wasn't our dresser.
No. What was that like, having Molly looking after you?
It was very chaotic.
Really?
Yeah. We had road crews hiring lifts to lift our gear into pubs because they were too lazy to do it.
Really? Now, I want to know about Jesus Christ Superstar. I'm a huge musicals fan. I don't care. What were you in Jesus Christ Superstar?
I started off as an apostle.
Oh, of course you did.
You know, as you do. And I was actually the understudy for Jesus.
No!
John Paul Young's part, which was a priest. And Stevie Wright's part, which was Simon Zealots.
Gee!
Yeah, yeah.
Did you get to go on? Did you break
I went on the
legs?
Cross. I went on the cross down at the Palais, and my mum was there, and my aunties. They go, David, Billy!
It's a good musical, the JCS.
Yes, it's a very hard role.
It is a hard role, and I can imagine you did it swimmingly. Yeah. Now, what was the first concert you ever went to, Billy?
It was The Who, Small Faces, and John Paul Jones, I think his name was, from Manfred Mann at Festival Hall in 1967. And he actually opened the show. He was, first on at 8 o'clock with Pretty Flamingo, which was number one, in the world. He wasn't even second best. Then came the Small Faces, and then the roadie started hammering in Keith Moon's drum kit to the floor. Big nails, just hammering them in.
And how old were you, Billy?
14.
Oh, 14. Oh. And you get to see The Who. That's unfair for all of us here.
Yeah.
Our two contestants are here. They make our two teams of six. Quizzes, we're ready for takeoff. The last time I looked, our first round was called Local and or General. Titles after titles. What are the words in brackets after these titles? Come up and see me.
Make me smile.
Thank you, Aaron, that's correct. Sweet dreams.
I'm made of these.
Well done, you're an IT guy and yet, there you go, well done. Pride. Yes.
In the name of love.
Oh, look, too quick. Wherever I lay my hat.
That's my home.
Well done, did you feel like you had to share that with the team?
I did, I wanted to confer
lovely.
A bit.
Yeah. Showing off or sharing? Who knows? Anyway.
Maybe showing off.
Who were the two female musicians who became part of Prince's band, The Revolution, during the 1980s? Oh.
Wendy and Lisa.
Do you spend any other time on the IT doing anything else?
You can get a lot done.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. You're very young to know all about Wendy and Lisa.
Remember Batman soundtrack?
Yeah. Look at me, just been corrected. There you go. He's hot. What is the first song on side two of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band?
Within You, Without You.
Freak, correct. What is the connection between Joni Mitchell, Paul McCartney and Starbucks?
They're on that record label, Starbucks record label.
Yeah, they are. Hear Music, it's called. Clever. Misheard lyrics. What should this lyric have been and who sang it? I got shoes. They're made of plywood.
I've got chills, they're multiplying.
Very good, lady. Who is that by? What's it from?
Greece.
Greece it is. And who sang it?
John Travolta.
And but it was in a film with Olivia Newton-John as well, so that's kind
you
of...
You got it.
Nice. You see, you could have got that.
I couldn't have.
Oh. Sing the next line and identify the artist and song title. Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby.
Oh, Billy, who sang that?
Judy Garland.
What's it called?
Over the Rainbow.
That's 15 points right there. like this lyric. Agadoo-doo-doo.
Push pineapple, push the tree. Pull pineapple, push the tree.
I can't even believe you know the first two words. I'm going to give that to you, Aaron. It is, in fact, push pineapple, shake the tree. How do you know that?
Oh, I used to live in England and they had those terrible novelty number ones all the time and that was one of them.
Well, that's terrific. Yeah, push pineapple, shake the tree, agadoo-doo-doo. Push pineapple, grind coffee, to the left, to the right, jump up, down, up. What?
Stop it.
Hey, hey, hey.
Stop it now.
That is the... This isn't a Rockwiz crowd, this is the Daggy crowd. All right, who sang it, actually?
Black Lace.
How do you know? You see, people write to us at SBS and Rockwiz and say, where do you get them from? The Nut House!
You know why he's so smart?
Why?
He's got three A's in his name.
I know! Is that right? Have we spelled it correctly?
Have you done put three A's on there?
Yeah.
No, that'd be...
Aaron.
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 No, that'd be wrong.
Oh, well, let's just pretend there's an O in it. Would that be right? Aaron, that's all right. Complete this lyric. Everybody's talking at me.
I can't hear a word they say. Only the echoes of my mind.
Oh, Billy, that's so beautiful. But who sang it?
Nilsson.
Good. And what's it called, the song?
Everybody's talking.
15 yeah. points right there. Very nice. I took you to an intimate restaurant.
Shut up. You put that in there so I would get one.
Would you like to
then do a suggested movie?
Yep.
There's nothing left to talk about unless it's horizontally.
Let's get
physical.
Physical.
Very good.
All I know. But you know what? That really went over really well with my grandparents at our family barbecues because they would ask me to sing and I would sing that song. So.
And how did that work out for you?
Oh, Steffi, that's a lovely song you've chosen.
What's the name of the song?
Physical.
Correct. And who sang it?
Miss Olivia Newton-John.
That's absolutely correct. Dave and Brian, scores are locked if you don't know. Gentlemen, the riff you have just heard is the mere tip of the iceberg. In Million Dollar Riff, our competitors must successfully identify a bunch of riffs. It's a mighty challenge, but I'm sure our Rockwizzes are up for it. Band, do your thing. Of delight. Yes, Belinda.
Hunger Like the Wolf, Duran Duran.
Well done, Belinda. Excellent. I adored them. I went and saw them support Robbie Williams, and I was the only 40-year-old woman amidst a sea of 16-year-olds waiting for Robbie going, who are they? No idea. Neil, confidence will be rewarded.
Thank you. It's Badge by Cream.
Yes, full points. All right. Riff number three.
Mm-hmm.
anyway. Yes, who buzzed?
I buzzed.
Was it you, Billy?
It's I'm just waiting for a friend.
And who sang it?
Keith and what's the other bloke? Lips.
Lips.
Mick.
Mick is correct. The Rolling Stones. Well done. And this riff. That second bit kicks in and goes, oh, yeah. But you were like fire.
Well, they were a favourite band.
Were they
when
loved?
I was young.
Who? Tell us.
That's the Specials.
What's the name of the song?
That'd be Ghost Town.
It yes. would be Ghost Town. Can I have some scores, please? Australian or New Zealander? Yes, no, not that. I haven't started. But yes, correct. Sharon O'Neill. Yes.
New Zealander.
Correct. Tim Finn. Yes.
New Zealand.
Well done, Stephanie.
Thank you.
Correct. Evermore.
New Zealand.
Correct. Edmund Hillary.
New Zealander.
Correct. Oh, that's it. Well done. Can we have some scores, please?
Is it an Australian or is it a New Zealander?
Is that tune not funkier than a truckload of funkiness driving down Funk Boulevard on its way to Funky Town? It signals, of course, a little bauble we call Master Blaster, where our special guests find themselves grilled on a subject of their choosing. We will begin with Stephanie. And your topic, oh, God, love you, the Olivia Newton-John, the 1981 album, Physical!
Thank you. That's like seeing my first teddy bear. Sing that record.
What is it about it for you? What do you love about her and why?
I mean, it was just my first record. And,
yep.
You know, I wasn't even born yet when I bought it because I'm not that old, but...
Yes. backpedal.
But, yeah, so I just had a Fisher-Price record player and I just listened to it until it was just not even making human sounds anymore.
Beautiful. Yeah. All right, well...
I love it.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Who produced the Physical album and how did his wife, Pat, figure in Olivia's early career?
Are you guys going to judge me because I know this? It's John Farrar.
No, we're going to be amazed if you get it.
It's John Farrar, and he also co-wrote lots of the songs.
Yes.
And I think his wife was one of Olivia's friends, like best friends or something like that.
That's pretty good. Yes, John Farrar was the producer. He was married to Pat. And Pat performed with Olivia in a swinging 60s Dolly Bird duo, imaginatively titled Pat and Olivia. She's not very bright, but God, we love her.
She's bright. She's very shiny.
Yeah. What item of clothing was popularized by the video for Physical?
I would have to say a snow white, 100% cotton, terry cloth, double rope twisted headband.
Absolutely correct! That is more detail than I had there. I mean, that's
all right here.
That's terrific.
It was very important to me.
Yep. What was the second single from the LP, Stephanie?
Shall I sing it?
Please sing it.
Come on, baby, make a move on me. Yeah?
That's absolutely correct.
Now I know.
But seriously, Stephanie, track 5 on side 2 is The Promise.
Yeah.
What's it about?
Well, let me talk to you guys about this. It's about dolphins. It's the dolphin song. And she wants to help to right a wrong with the dolphin song. And if she could only do that, then she would be fulfilling the promise. And it's very important.
You are 100% correct.
Thanks.
I may tear up. I mean, that was quite beautiful.
I feel it.
Olivia thanks Kaleo and Mikioi on the back cover. Just who are Kaleo and Mikioi?
I could do their voices.
Yeah, please.
Mikioi!
Sorry?
They're the dolphins.
They are the dolphins, in fact. Very good.
Could we... Stephanie, could we hear the voices again?
That's beautiful.
Thanks.
Stephanie, you have just scored your team a full set of points
right there.
And now we turn our attention to the rock and roll warrior that is Billy Miller.
Ooh,
now, Billy, your nominated topic this evening is legendary rock venues of this big, beautiful land. Brilliant.
Thank you.
Absolutely. We've never had it before. And you would have seen quite a few venues, I should imagine.
Well, I've seen most of them, but I'm glad you picked that instead of my other one. Well, ugliest singers the last 50 years.
Oh, we'll have to get you to come back and do that.
Yes.
That sounds like a Christmas show, don't you think? Are you ready to go?
Yep.
At which Sydney venue did the volume of Billy Thorpe's Aztecs allegedly kill the goldfish in the room's aquariums?
The Bondi Lifesaver.
The Bondi Lifesaver is correct.
Yeah, it's got to be the Bondi Lifesaver.
Did it have big aquariums?
It had a big fish tank along the bar there, yeah.
And allegedly they died.
They died, but they nearly died before that because Swanee used to sort of... You know, John Swan used to dance along the top of it as well, so that almost killed him. But Billy wrote him off with his first big chord in Oop Oop A Doo.
Oh.
Yeah.
Name the former Queensland venue that was on the beach, near a bird sanctuary and a dropkick away from the Tullabudgera Creek.
The Gold Coast Playroom.
You're absolutely
the best
correct.
Sound of any venue in the whole of Australia.
I think.
Yeah.
Can you categorically state that?
I can because, I heard it. But
Which Melbourne pub was the venue for a live album that featured the Dingoes, the Carl Myriad Band, Saltbush?
TF Much Ballroom.
No. It's in Prahran.
Oh no, I'm really letting these blokes down. Yeah.
No, well, they've got plenty of points already. But Stephanie did shine with ONJ.
You did. You killed me on that.
I'm going to have to say the Station Hotel in Prahran.
Oh, of course, it's where I grew up. Oh, not in the pub, but next to it.
Now, look, we tried to cover all the Australian states for your questions, Billy, but we missed out on Western Australia and Tasmania. What are your favourite venues in those states?
Well, the Sand Groper in... just because of its name, it had to be. And because we got horribly ripped off there and the band broke up, but...
Oh, happy times.
Yeah. And I had to play for 3 months in Perth as Billy McCartney. I did Paul McCartney songs like Blackbird at lunchtimes for 3 months to get the train fare back. Yeah.
What's the buzz? Tell me what's happening. A bit of JCS. Yeah, you could have got a bit of Jesus.
Look.
And what about, what was the other place? Tasmania.
Tassie. There was Peter Hudson, the greatest full forward of all time, probably. He had a good venue down there that we all played at, but I don't remember much of that decade.
Hey, Dad.
And that's what I like, an honest musician. And finally... In the late 70s, members of an Australian band were organising transport to a much-loved after-hours club in Adelaide. They tossed up getting 2 taxis or a car to the Ark Bar. What was the song that they wrote on the way? Who was the band and who was the bass player in the band?
The bass player?
Yes.
The great Mark Ferry, who is in our presence at the moment.
Mark Ferry.
The band was The Models.
Yes.
One of the best bands of all time. And what was the other? Oh, the Toucan Club.
What was the name of the song?
Two cabs to the toucan.
Excellent work. Full points right there for Billy. Can I have some scores, please? Is setting fast on another episode of Rockwiz. But before we turn on the porch light and put the bins out, orchestra, tease us with a little tune. Yes! Rockwizzes, it's been a privilege asking you your questions this evening. Good luck in your future endeavours and may your non-denominational deity be with you. Your time starts...
now.
Name the instruments we associate with the following virtuosos. James Morrison.
Trumpet.
Correct. Ross Hannaford.
Guitar.
Correct. Warren Ellis.
Violin.
Correct. Stefan Grappelli.
Violin.
You're on fire, Billy. And I'm enjoying it. Jean-Luc Ponty.
Also violin.
Well done, Aaron. There's a little competition going here. Lucky Oceans.
Lap steel guitar.
Yes.
Ooh. Detail. Earl Scruggs.
Banjo.
Correct. Yes. Which bad boy of country music wrote and sang the Dukes of Hazzard intro music? Yes.
Waylon Jennings.
You are right. There. By the way, Waylon Jennings, the man who gave up his seat for the Big Bopper on that fateful aeroplane. Oh, that was the wrong decision. Who joined Waylon in the country supergroup The Highwaymen? Yes.
Willie Nelson.
Yes.
Johnny Cash.
Yes.
Chris Christopherson. Yes.
Young but fresh, he knows his answers. Which of The Highwaymen are still alive?
Willie Nelson.
Yes.
And Chris Christopherson. Yes.
And looking good, quietly. Which of the highwaymen claimed on the David Letterman show that he smoked marijuana on the White House roof while visiting President Jimmy Carter? Had to get that in because it's kind of interesting. Yes.
Smoking Willie Nelson.
Smoking Willie Nelson is correct. Which highway did Bob Dylan revisit?
61.
Correct. Where were AC/DC heading on their highway? Yep. Did you know that, Stephanie?
Yes.
Good.
To hell.
To hell is correct. Good girl. On what highway would we find Nutbush City Limits? Ooh. Oh, Aaron is stumped. I like to know about this. Come on, Belinda.
19.
Highway number 19. Yes. Ooh, lucky. Ooh, I nearly threw it to Neil. Name the members of Latin flamenco band Poco Loco who recently toured Norway. Yes.
William Miller.
Yes.
Barry Ferrier and Brian Woppert.
Mr. William Miller, right there. Thank you very much.
And it was light the whole time.
What?
The sun never went down because we were inside the Arctic Circle. So
is that weird?
We were walking home from the gig at 3 o'clock in the sunlight.
Oh, gee.
Mm.
I couldn't handle that.
Me neither.
Yeah. Most rock and rollers can't wait to leave school, but many of them write about it. Who gave us these school songs? School's out.
Alice Cooper?
Oh, correct.
Okay, thanks. I surprised myself.
You did. That was great. Not sure I'm going to go for it. Rock and Roll High School. Yep.
The Ramones.
Correct. Nude School. Yep.
Painters and Dockers.
Nice. School Days. Yep.
Chuck Berry.
Good one. My Old School.
Steely Dan.
Mais j'en ai marre. I can't believe it.
Scores are level.
Ooh. Catholic Schoolgirls Rule.
Chili Peppers.
Yes.
Well done. Yes, correct, Anthony. Me and Julio down by the schoolyard.
Simon and Garfunkel.
Paul Simon. Paul Simon.
Paul Simon.
Paul Simon.
Pay That.
Pay That. Oh, God. I mean, there's a car and a holiday at stake. I'm glad you're really paying attention. I don't like Mondays.
Boomtown Rats.
Welcome. Another brick in the wall.
Pink Floyd.
Well done.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
That's it. It's all over. Brian and Dave, to whom do the spoils of victory go? That was great play. It was a bit like a grand final, but it's not. Thank you to all of tonight's Rockwizzers. Technically, we could have done it without you, but the show would have been a disaster. That's it for another week. Don't forget, if you crave more one-on-one time with us, simply jump onto our website. It's only a www away. And remember, as French writer Voltaire once said, anything that is too stupid to be spoken is sung. To take us out tonight, Stephanie and Billy are going to serenade us with a hit from blue-eyed soul singer Len Barry. It was on John Lennon's jukebox. It's 1, 2, 3. Sayonara. Aztecs allegedly kill the goldfish in the room's aquariums.
The Bondi Lifesaver.
The Bondi Lifesaver is correct.
Yeah, it's got to be the Bondi Lifesaver.
Did it have big aquariums?
It had a big fish tank along the bar there, yeah.
And allegedly they died.
They nearly died before that because Swanee used to sort of, you know, John Swanee used to dance along the top of it as well. So that almost killed him. But Billy wrote him off with his first big chord in Oop Oop A Doo.
Oh.
Yeah.
Name the former Queensland venue that was on the beach near a bird sanctuary and a dropkick away from the Tullabudgera Creek.
The Gold Coast Playroom.
You're absolutely
the best
correct.
Sound of any venue in the whole of Australia, I
really?
Think. Yeah.
Can you categorically state that?
I can because, well, I heard it, but...
Which Melbourne pub was the venue for a live album that featured the Dingoes, the Carl Myriad Band, Saltbush...
TF Much Ballroom.
No. It's in Prahran.
Oh, no, I'm really letting these blokes down. Yeah.
No, well, they've got plenty of points already. But Stephanie did shine with ONJ.
You did. You killed me on that.
I'm going to have to say the Station Hotel in Prahran.
Oh, of course, it's where I grew up. Oh, not in the pub, but next to it.
Now, look, we tried to cover all the Australian states for your questions, Billy, but we missed out on Western Australia and Tasmania. What are your favourite venues in those states?
Well, the Sand Grober in... just because of its name, it had to be. And because we got horribly ripped off there and the band broke up, but...
Oh, happy times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I had to play for 3 months in Perth as Billy McCartney. I did Paul McCartney songs like Blackbird at lunchtimes for 3 months to get the train fare back. Yeah.
What's the buzz? Tell me what's happening. A bit
what's
of JCS.
Yeah,
you could have got a bit of Jesus.
Look.
And what about, what was the other place? Tasmania.
Oh, Tassie. There was Peter Hudson, the greatest full forward of all time, probably. He had a good venue down there that we all played at, but I don't remember much of that decade.
Hey, that.
And that's what I like, an honest musician. And finally... In the late 70s, members of an Australian band were organising transport to a much-loved after-hours club in Adelaide. They tossed up getting two taxis or a car to the Ark Bar. What was the song that they wrote on the way? Who was the band and who was the bass player in the band?
The bass player?
Yes.
The great Mark Ferry, who was in our...
As a 15-year-old watching Countdown, where that song was number one for so many weeks, it went, oh, not again, but it was a huge success.
Yeah.
It went gold, and Molly Meldrum was your manager.
And our producer.
And your producer.
Our dresser? No.
Your dresser.
Wasn't our dresser.
No. What was that like, having Molly looking after you?
It was very chaotic.
Really?
Yeah. We had road crews hiring lifts to lift our gear into pubs because they were too lazy to do it.
Really? Now, I want to know about Jesus Christ Superstar. I'm a huge musicals fan. I don't care. What were you in Jesus Christ Superstar?
I started off as an apostle.
Oh, of course you did.
You know, as you do. And I was actually the understudy for Jesus.
No!
John Paul Young's part, which was a priest. And Stevie Wright's part, which was Simon Zealots.
Gee!
Yeah, yeah.
Did you get to go on? Did you break
I went on
your
the
legs?
Cross. I went on the cross down at the Palais and my mum was there and my aunties. Oh. They go, take it, Billy!
Oh. It's a good musical, the JCS.
Yes, it's a very hard role.
It is a hard role and I can imagine you did it swimmingly. Yeah. Now, what was the first concert you ever went to, Billy?
It was The Who, Small Faces... And John Paul Jones, I think his name was, from Manfred Mann at Festival Hall in 1967. And he actually opened the show. He was, first on at 8 o'clock with Pretty Flamingo, which was number one, you know, in the world. He wasn't even second best. Then came the Small Faces and then the roadie started hammering in Keith Moon's drum kit to the floor. Big nails just hammering them in.
And how old were you, Billy?
14.
Oh, 14. Oh. And you get to see The Who. That's unfair for all of us here.
Yeah.
Our two contestants are here. They make our two teams of six. Quizzes, we're ready for takeoff. The last time I looked, our first round was called Local and or General. titles after titles. What are the words in brackets after these titles? Come up and see me.
Make me smile.
Thank you, Aaron, that's correct. Sweet dreams.
I'm made of these.
Well done, you're an IT guy and yet, there you go, well done. Pride. Yes.
In the name of love.
Oh, look, too quick. Wherever I lay my hat.
That's my home.
Well done. Did you feel like you had to share that with the team?
I did. I wanted to confer a bit.
Yeah. Showing off or sharing?
Look.
And what about, what was the other place? Tasmania.
Oh, Tassie. There was Peter Hudson, the greatest full forward of all time, probably. He had a good venue down there that we all played at, but I don't remember much of that decade.
Hey, that.
And that's what I like, an honest musician. And finally, in the late 70s, members of an Australian band were organising transport to a much-loved after-hours club in Adelaide. They tossed up getting two taxis or a car to the Ark Bar. What was the song that they wrote on the way? Who was the band and who was the bass player in the band?
The bass player?
Yes.
The great Mark Ferry, who
yes,
is in our presence
the
at
great
the moment.
Mark Ferry.
The band was The Models.
Yes.
One of the best bands of all time. And what was the other? Oh, the Toucan Club.
What was the name of the song?
Two cabs to the toucan.
Excellent work. Full points right there for Billy. Can I have some scores, please? Is setting fast on another episode of Rockwiz. But before we turn on the porch light and put the bins out, orchestra, tease us with a little tune. Yes! Rockwizzes, it's been a privilege asking you your questions this evening. Good luck in your future endeavours and may your non-denominational deity be with you. Your time starts...
now.
Name the instruments we associate with the following virtuosos. James Morrison.
Trumpet.
Correct. Ross Hannaford.
Guitar.
Correct. Warren Ellis.
Violin.
Correct. Stefan Grappelli.
Violin.
You're on fire, Billy. And I'm enjoying it. Jean-Luc Ponty.
Also violin.
Well done, Aaron. There's a little competition going here. Lucky Oceans.
Lap steel guitar.
Yes.
Ooh. Detail. Earl Scruggs.
Banjo.
Correct. Yes. Which bad boy of country music wrote and sang the Dukes of Hazzard intro music? Yes.
Waylon Jennings.
You are right. There. By the way, Waylon Jennings, the man who gave up his seat for the Big Bopper on that fateful aeroplane. Oh, that was the wrong decision. Who joined Waylon? We are delighted to have you here.
Thanks.
Now, Stephanie, it's not often that one can say one has grown up on a peacock farm. What does that entail?
Sort of maybe coaxing them and then milking them.
No. You don't milk a peacock, do you?
You do. Yes, you absolutely do. I do.
Sure. And well, you might. And were they always fanning themselves open?
All the time, constantly.
Mainly the men, I understand. The peahen is not particularly beautiful, but the peacock is a delight.
Lovely.
Lovely, good.
The best milk.
The best milk, naturally. You and I share a passion.
Oh.
Olivia Newton-John. Really? Olivia Newton-John.
You understand?
Yes, I understand.
Thank you.
I understand. And we will talk about that later on.
That's
but it's
great.
Wonderful to meet someone who's on the same level.
I'm
it's very
on the page
exciting.
That you are on.
Oh, you are on. Now, out of interest, Stephanie, the first concert you ever went to?
I honestly can't remember if it was Crosby, Stills and Nash or the Sugar Cubes. But it was one of those.
Gee, that's pretty good news.
I know. It was the same week because it was a festival, so.
And how was Björk? Was she great?
Yeah. Oh. She's wearing a big yellow jumpsuit that looked kind of like she was just awesome.
Of course she was. Yes. I love you a little bit more now, Stephanie.
Thanks.
Because you've mentioned Björk. And first album or CD you ever bought of your own money?
Miss Olivia Newton-John physical. $7 at Target.
Target, okay. Yeah, that's where all the good music comes from, Target, I do believe. Stephanie, you're a delight. Welcome. Now, who is next on board? Stephanie has been meted and greeted, but who will match musical brains with her? Without further ado...
Hi.
Anthony, have you come from work? You look like you're in a business shirt. What do you do for a crust?
Oh, IT work.
Don't apologise, we all need it.
I'm cool with it. Pearl Jam at Exhibition Park in Canberra.
Oh, but Canberra didn't know what hit it when Pearl Jam came.
Yeah, it was cool.
Good grief. And your first album?
It'd be Prince Batman soundtrack.
Sometimes a movie opens up a whole world of music for one. Well done. Hello, Belinda, another woman on the team. Very happy with that. Belinda, first concert?
It was Silverchair at Festival Hall.
Oh, lovely. How old were they at this stage?
Very young.
Very young, yeah. Freaks, one and all. Extraordinary. And your first album?
It's really, really embarrassing.
No, come on.
This is really embarrassing.
All right.
E17, Walthamstow.
Well, Belinda, I do believe that is embarrassing. And... But that's why we're here. We purge and we move on. Well done. And finally, Aaron, welcome.
Hi, Julian.
Woo!
On the table. Oh.
Now, the first concert you ever went to?
That was Cole Chisel's Last Stand.
Oh.
At the Perth Entertainment Centre.
Oh, there you go.
I was 12 and the bloke who brought me is my cousin and he's here tonight.
Oh, so that's a lovely full circle. Look at that. Well, now the circle is almost complete. Except for the bit where it joins up. To complete our metaphorical ring, we must meet tonight's two musicians. But who can they be now? Who can it be now? I was born in the United States and was raised on a peacock farm in Wisconsin. My favourite things as a child were my pet swan, my pet fox, and an old guitar that I found in a dusty attic. It was during a busy peacock feather harvest that I started writing songs for the boys at school, my pets, and some of the ghosts that lived on the farm. These days I record my songs on a tape player called Jean-Pierre. I'm based in London now and working with Simon Raymond from the Cocteau Twins. Although at the moment I've been touring Australia with my friend Holly Throsby.
Stephanie Dosen.
Please make her very welcome. After these titles. Come up and see me.
Make Me Smile.
Thank you, Aaron, that's correct. Sweet Dreams.
I'm made of these.
Well done, you're an IT guy and yet there you go, well done. Pride. Yes.
In the Name of Love.
Oh, look, too quick. Wherever I lay my hat.
That's my home.
Well done. Did you feel like you had to share that with the team?
I did. I wanted to confer a bit.
Yeah. Showing off or sharing? Who knows? Anyway.
Maybe showing off.
Who were the two female musicians who became part of Prince's band, The Revolution, during the 1980s? Oh.
Wendy and Lisa.
Do you spend any other time on the IT doing anything else?
You can get a lot done.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. You're very young to know all about Wendy and Lisa.
Remember Batman soundtrack?
Yeah. Look at me, just been corrected. There you go. He's hot. What is the first song on side two of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band?
Within You, Without You.
Freak, correct. What is the connection between Joni Mitchell, Paul McCartney and Starbucks?
They're on that record label, Starbucks record label.
Yeah, they are. Hear Music, it's called. Clever. Misheard lyrics. What should this lyric have been and who sang it? I got shoes, they're made of plywood.
I've got chills, they're multiplying.
Very good, lady. Who is that by? What's it from?
Greece.
Greece it is. And who sang it?
John Travolta.
And but it wasn't a film with Olivia Newton-John as well, so that's kind of...
You got it.
Nice. You see, you could have got that.
I couldn't have.
Oh. Sing the next line and identify the artist and song title. Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby.
Oh, Billy, who sang that?
Judy Garland.
What's it called?
Over the Rainbow.
That's 15 points right there. Complete this lyric. Agga do, do, do.
Push pineapple, push the tree. Pull pineapple, push the tree.
I can't even believe you know the first two words. I'm going to give that to you, Aaron. It is, in fact, push pineapple, shake the tree. How do you know that?
Oh, I used to live in England and they had those terrible novelty number ones all the time and that was one of them.
Well, that's terrific. Yeah, push pineapple, shake the tree, agga do, do, do. Push pineapple, grind coffee, to the left, to the... What's it from?
Greece.
Greece it is. And who sang it?
John Travolta.
And, but it wasn't a film with Olivia Newton-John as well, so that's kind of...
You got it.
Nice. You see, you could have got that.
I couldn't have.
Oh. Sing the next line and identify the artist and song title. Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby.
Oh, Billy, who sang that?
Judy Garland.
What's it called?
Over the Rainbow.
That's 15 points right there. Complete this lyric. Agga do, do, do.
Push pineapple, push the tree. Pull pineapple, push the tree.
I can't even believe you know the first two words. I'm going to give that to you, Aaron. It is, in fact, push pineapple, shake the tree. How do you know that?
Oh, I used to live in England and they had those terrible novelty number ones all the time and that was one of them.
Well, that's terrific. Yeah, push pineapple, shake the tree, agga do, do, do. Push pineapple, grind coffee, to the left, to the right, jump up, down, a... What?
Stop it.
Hey, hey, hey.
Stop it now.
That is the... This isn't a Rockwiz crowd, this is a Daggy crowd. All right, who sang it, actually?
Black Lace.
How do you know? You see, people write to us at SBS and Rockwiz and say, where do you get them from? The Nut House!
You know why he's so smart?
Why?
He's got three A's in his name.
I know! Is that right? Have we spelled it correctly?
Have you done put three A's on there?
Yeah.
No, that'd be...
Aaron.
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 No, that'd be wrong.
Oh, well, let's just pretend there's an O in it. Would that be right? Aaron, that's all right. Complete this lyric. Everybody's talking at me.
I can't hear a word they're saying, only the echoes of my mind.
Oh, Billy, that's so beautiful. But who sang it?
Nilsson.
Good. And what's it called, the song?
Everybody's Talking.
15 yeah. points right there. Very nice. I took you to an intimate restaurant.
Shut up. You put that in there so I would get one.
Would you like to
then
complete?
Do a suggested movie?
Yep.
There's nothing left to talk about unless it's horizontally.
Let's get Stephanie, welcome. We are delighted to have you here.
Thanks.
Now, Stephanie, it's not often that one can say one has grown up on a peacock farm. What does that entail?
Sort of maybe coaxing them and then milking them.
No. You don't milk a peacock, do you?
You do. Yes, you absolutely do. I do.
Sure. And well, you might. And surround them, were they always fanning themselves open?
All the time, constantly.
Mainly the men, I understand. The peahen is not particularly beautiful, but the peacock is a delight.
Lovely.
Lovely, good.
The best milk.
The best milk. Naturally. You and I share a passion.
Oh.
Olivia Newton-John. Really? Olivia Newton-John.
You understand?
Yes, I understand.
Thank you.
I understand. And we will talk about that later on.
That's
but
great.
It's wonderful to meet someone who's on the same level.
I'm
it's very
on the page
exciting.
That you are on.
Oh, you are on. Now, out of interest, Stephanie, the first concert you ever went to?
I honestly can't remember if it was Crosby, Stills and Nash or the Sugar Cubes. But it was one of those.
Gee, that's pretty good news.
I know. It was the same week because it was a festival, so.
And how was Björk? Was she great?
Yeah. Oh. She's wearing a big yellow jumpsuit that looked kind of like she was just awesome.
Of course she was. Yes, yes. I love you a little bit more now, Stephanie,
Thanks.
Because you've mentioned Björk. And first album or CD you ever bought of your own money?
Miss Olivia Newton-John physical. $7 at Target.
Target, okay. Yeah, that's where all the good music comes from, Target, I do believe. Stephanie, you're a delight. Welcome. Now, who is next on board? Stephanie has been meted and greeted, but who will match musical brains with her? Without further ado, who can it be now? Depending on who you talk to, I'm either a walking encyclopedia of the history of the St Kilda Football Club, or one of Australia's greatest bad boy rock stars of the 70s. Either or both is fine by me. I started performing in the 60s and my first break came in the original cast of Jesus Christ, in the early 70s. Sorry, had to do that. I ferreted around for a while in the 70s, but I knew the key to success was not to fall in love. Yes, Neil.
Billy Miller?
Please, make him very welcome. Billy Miller! Lyric. Agga do do do.
Push pineapple, push the tree. Pull pineapple, push the tree.
I can't even believe you know the first two words. I'm going to give that to you, Aaron. It is, in fact, push pineapple, shake the tree. How do you know that?
Oh, I used to live in England and they had those terrible novelty number ones all the time, and that was one of them.
Well, that's terrific. Yeah, push pineapple, shake the tree, agga do, do, do. Push pineapple, grind coffee, to the left, to the right, jump up, down, a... What?
Stop it.
Hey, hey, hey.
Stop it now.
That is not... This isn't a Rockwiz crowd, this is a Daggy crowd. All right, who sang it, actually?
Black Lace.
How do you know? You see, people write to us at SBS and Rockwiz and say, where do you get them from? The Nut House!
You know why he's so smart?
Why?
He's got three A's in his name.
I know! Is that right? Have we spelled it correctly?
Have you done put three A's on there?
Yeah.
No, that'd be...
Aaron.
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 Now that'd be wrong.
Oh, well, let's just pretend there's an O in it. Would that be right? Aaron, that's all right. Complete this lyric. Everybody's talking at me.
I can't hear a word they're saying, only the echoes of my mind.
Oh, Billy, that's so beautiful. But who sang it?
Nilsson.
Good. And what's it called, the song?
Everybody's talking.
15 yeah. points right there. Very nice. I took you to an intimate restaurant.
Shut up. You put that in there so I would get one.
Would you like to complete?
Then do a suggested movie.
Yep.
There's nothing left to talk about unless it's horizontally.
Let's get
physical.
Physical. Very good.
Thanks. All I know. But you know what? That really went over really well with my grandparents at our family barbecues, because they would ask me to sing and I would sing that song. So.
And how did that work out for you?
Oh, Steffi, that's a lovely song you've chosen.
What's the name of the song?
Physical.
Correct. And who sang it?
Miss Olivia Newton-John.
That's absolutely correct. Dave and Brian, scores are locked if you don't know. As a 15-year-old watching Countdown, where that song was number one for so many weeks, it went, oh, not again, but it was a huge success. Yeah. It went gold, and Molly Meldrum was your...